So on 30th November, I paid 2.3 million to Vivo Energy Kenya. And I was supplied with the fuel the following day. But to my surprise, as I was waiting for the lorry to come, the lorry was accompanied by the area manager, who actually came up accompanied by Kimondo's family, who actually operates the other station in town. I have a QM here who actually goes to check whether the fuel is offloaded in the right manner. But he could not be allowed to inspect the lorry. Later, I came to learn that the fuel which is actually being put in the tank was less than the order which was than the fuel which was supposed to be supplied. And I started complaining by then. They pressed an order for this station of lubricants of 5 tons without my permission, without consultation from my end, because we are supposed to make orders from here, but it is not supposed to be done from the office, from that shell. And the lubricants which were supplied to this station actually are lubricants which do not move. Yeah, you know, there are those lubricants which normally customers don't want. So I have it there as a dead stock which I'm supposed to pay. That is the worst part of it.
So when we came to debrand the site, because it was out of stock for intermittently over 3 weeks, and for the last 7 days it has not had any fuel, because the dealer in this particular station lacked working capital. And when my people came in the morning, when I sent them to debrand the station, because we don't allow stations to go dry, they encountered resistance. So they called me and told me they were encountering resistance, and because he's a senior person in society, I came to cool him down and to talk to him to allow the people to continue with the work. Instead, what I was met with is gunshots and threats, and these were captured on camera. So I was very, very surprised that a senator in the Republic of Kenya can actually threaten a chief executive officer of an investor. We have not seen any court order. Nothing has been served on us. I saw a piece of paper at the station that is referring to the dealer agreement. But a dealer agreement is a legal document between us and dealers, and that's a standard agreement. Well, the rule of law applies. We have recorded a statement, a threat to my life, a real threat, where gunshots were shot, and we'll allow the law to take its course, and I thank the police for their cooperation. I really would like to apologize to all motorists coming on. We were hoping that you'll have a very nice journey stop and get your V-Power in Naivasha. We unfortunately have to close that station for a period until we unravel the dispute that is ongoing. But there are very many other stations available for motorists between Nairobi and